Hi, my name is Danny Guillory. I'm a senior product manager on the Microsoft Intune team. And today we're going to talk about how to keep your applications updated and secure using Microsoft Intune Suite. So today we're going to start and say, welcome to the Intune Suite. So here you can see on this slide, there's a whole bunch of products within the Intune Suite or capabilities, whichever way you like to look at it, that make up the Microsoft Intune Suite. Today, what we're going to be talking about is advanced app management. Quick agenda of what we'll go over today is really a high-level summary. We'll talk about the problem, solution, and then we'll go through a recap. So I've been waiting a long time to say this, but welcome to advanced app management. It's been a while that I've been looking into this, researching it, talking to customers, spending a lot of time. So it's good to finally see the work that myself and my dev team have put in, actually finally making it out there. So I'm going to start off with a high-level summary. You're going to get access to a comprehensive and enterprise-ready catalog of Windows applications. These applications are going to be easily discoverable as well as deployable and directly from within Intune. Once you combine Microsoft Intune and MDE together, we're going to be able to provide you with a rich set of actions and insights for you to make better decisions on how those applications can and should be updated within your estate. So at the bottom, you can see three core pillars that I've basically called out here. You have Microsoft Intune, Microsoft Defender for Endpoints, and then the new addition, which is the Enterprise App Catalog. So one of the things, the way I like to have these conversations is, why should you care? And then, you know, what we internalize is, what is the problem? Today, like 100%, you're already exposed. If you don't know it, now you know it. You're already exposed. You already have outdated applications in your estate. Because those applications are outdated, they're vulnerable. They're vulnerable whether right now, 5 minutes from now, 5 hours, 5 weeks, it doesn't matter. At some point in time, they are vulnerable. And that being said, really just takes me to my third bullet is there's no proactive awareness of those applications that need to be updated today. As I have these conversations with customers, I remember and reflect on my time when I was a customer. I never knew applications were needed updates until I tripped and fell over them. I was at home, I was somewhere else, and I got an alert that the app needed to be updated. Then I'd remember, oh yeah, we're using that at work too. I wonder if it needs to be updated at work. You're driving to the office or you're doing something casual and some media stream makes an announcement about an app that needs to be updated or an app that has a vulnerability. Like, you literally have no way of knowing if these applications need to be updated. And the other way that you would find out is once you get to the office, right? You're on your way to the office thinking you're going to do this, you know, this thing today or these set of things. And then all of a sudden your security guy is chasing you because you need to go update this app because his attack surface is growing. We're taking on more risks by the day, by the minute, by every device that turns on. So there's three ways you find out and none of them are proactive. So it's all reactive when you find out about an app that needs to be updated in your estate. So, you know, looking at this as a problem, acting on these outdated apps, vulnerable apps, they are time consuming, costly, inefficient, and the effectiveness can vary, spinning off many different work streams. I mean, think about it. Every time you've taken on an action that popped up or of an app that needs to be updated for whatever reason, vulnerable or not, you got to report on it. Somebody's got to go do the execution. Then somebody's got to track down the last mile. And then you still have to aggregate that all up and send it to somebody, that's at the next level for their visibility and accountability. So these things just create a whole different workflows for us. And those things we don't see until we're actually in it. We're in it. We're doing the thing to solve the problem. But then somebody asks about reporting, accountability, how do you find those devices that were offline or on vacation? So, you know, anyway, I can get on a soapbox there. But, you know, this is what I define as a problem. So let's talk about the solution and the things that the solution is going to do in the near future and maybe some of those things in the long term. So advanced app management is the solution. First thing you're going to see is an enterprise catalog show up within Intune. As long as you're a part of a customer of the Intune suite, you'll be able to see this catalog. It's directly integrated into Microsoft Intune. Microsoft is hosting the content and we're going to validate this content for you, exactly like we do our other content. Pre-configured Win32 applications, very large set of applications in this catalog. Numbers will come out later as we get closer to GA, and much, much faster time to value. You can see for here at the screenshot, there's a search bar at the top. Once the catalog pops up, type the application you want. In this case, I just typed Adobe, and then I get a list of Adobe products. You can see here, I can also even add a filter. Maybe I want to filter on version, publisher, or something else. Towards the bottom, you'll see I could pick different architectures, whether it be 64-bit or x86, and then also language. But once I select these options here, I can hit next, and then bam, right here, you'll see we're going to pre-fill all this information for you. We know all this information, the database that we curated that has all of this information. We're going to give it to you. We're going to pre-populate all this stuff so you don't have to put this in. This should incur significant time savings. You can see here, we populated the name. We also populate description. There'll be some fields that you really won't be able to change because that's kind of how it is today, especially if you're using Windows Store for Business. We pre-populate things. Some of the things you can't change. What you'll see also is that we are pre-filling in the information for you. So you can see we're pre-filling the silent install. We're pre-filling the uninstall command. We're also going to pre-fill in the install behavior, whether it be for system, for user. Two things not on this slide and most likely will not make this workflow is we just chose not to show you the detection method and requirements, but they are also pre-filled in also. We gave you these options, all of these options here, so that you can still have control. When we first started talking to customers about this capability, this feature, we had this idea of just check box, let it automatic update. But we decided to give customers a control because that's what the louder voice was. Customers wanted to see the command line. They wanted to provide changes to that command line if they wanted to. So we decided to go ahead in this first version to give you the ability to make those changes. Again, all of that is available for you to go make changes as you need. Again, detection method requirements. If you want to go make those changes, once you finish wizard, just hit edit. You can go back and see what was our detection method. What were the requirements? You should definitely go and investigate that if you're differently interested. So let's talk about app updates. Probably the more exciting part of the feature that I know I have spent a ton of time in and probably will live in this world for quite some time. When we look at the solution, again, I talked earlier about not knowing when an application needs to be updated, just oblivious to what that's going on today. So because we have this rich set of metadata that we'll use, we'll be able to show you right here in the console what applications need to be updated. So if you're a customer of the Intune suite today, what you'll see is this notification pane and updates for Windows Advanced Management apps. It sounds like a mouthful. We may make it shorter. I don't know, but that's what we're going to do is basically give you a pane to see all of these updates in one place. Now remember, these are updates for managed applications only. At some point in the future, we may investigate unmanaged applications, but for right now, we're sticking to your managed applications. So let's take another click into that and see what it looks like. So if we look more of what those controls are, as we talk about the solution, here's what that pane's going to look like. We're going to list all the managed applications that have available updates. So you can see here in this column, once I've selected that pane, I can see the name of the application. I can see the new version of the application. There's a lot of things here and even more things we may build into here because some of these columns I think can be more impactful. As a customer that I've been talking to quite a bit, one of the things that stands out is how do I know which update is more important to go after? How do I prioritize, especially if I have hundreds of thousands of apps? So there's some more innovation we're going to do here to help you know what's more important, what you should go after within your estate. We look at more at those app update controls. So I want to call out a few things. This slide right here, once you click the three dots that you saw on the previous screen, this will be a flyout pane. From this flyout pane, you'll be able to take action to update that application. You will also be able to show devices that are impacted. So if we just kind of look through the click through I got here, That area right there is where you would select to update the application. And this area, we would select to see, hey, what devices are going to be impacted? Everybody wants to know that, especially if you're updating an application that has a pretty high context in your estate. Maybe you want to be more touchy with that one. Maybe some you just click the next button and let it go and update. But anyway, you do want to see what your affected impact is across the estate. Here, we'll actually put in some app details. We'll show you, hey, the app name, file version, is it 5 megs, 10 megs, 20 megs, when it was released, release notes. You should have links to the documentation of that application also. So that's something else we'll add in. Last but not least, one of the fundamental things that I'm really focused on, and I really put in a yellow box because we may not get it in the early release, but we're definitely dead set on bringing this to the capability, is bringing in some more security context. Again, I remember being a IT pro myself and being a customer. And one thing that I wish I had that I'm trying to provide to you as customers is the ability to make better decisions. It would be nice to know if I'm updating the application because it has an update, or am I updating because of vulnerability? And then is the thing I'm updating to better or worse than what I'm already at? You may not need to update that application if the new update winds up having a higher security posture or a lower security posture, depending on how you look at that. So really giving you more signals to help you understand what decisions you're making to make the right decisions. Moving on. I'm going to talk about app supersedence because this was a core fundamental that we built off of. So in the previous screen, you saw that there was a three dots to the right of the line item. When you click the three dots, we're going to put you right here in the supersedence. We already know the application that needs to be updated. We also know the new update for the app. So it really made sense for us to leverage supersedence here and give you that capability to go through the same process that you go through today. It gives you the control you need and the control that I know customers asked for when I was first investigating the solution. So we give you supersedence. And from here, you can hit the back button if you want to go change, name, description, whatever options we left you. And it's definitely important. One thing I want to mention here, it's important to know because we built it on the platform we already had with supersedence as well as Win32, any of the capabilities with Win32 and supersedence, they're there. They're not going anywhere. We didn't put any artificial blocks in there because you were using the catalog. The catalog is going to help you give you this guided upgrade process and put the application in your tenant. That's the real big value here. You should, through this whole solution, you should not have to spend a lot of time downloading the package, downloading the tool, wrapping the tool, uploading it. I can go on and on. That process gets kind of daunting. So as you, from application acquisition, even through upgrade, this solution should help you be more efficient. There should be ways that you start thinking, hey, why do I need to wrap this app anymore? I could just go grab it from the catalog. Again, I digress, pulling this right back into supersedence and that update experience. Once you click the update experience, we will put you right into supersedence, and you can there choose still to make changes to things or not, description and name. And then you can come and say, hey, maybe you know that you need to uninstall that previous version before you install a new version. You totally have that control to go through and do that. So yeah, all yours, have at it. Go crazy with it. So quick recap, what is Advanced App Management? It's a cloud solution for Microsoft Intune customers to get better insights into third-party and first-party applications that are vulnerable within their estate today. What's in it for you would be the thing that I would ask if I was a customer. Hey, what's in it for me? It's going to be what we talked about earlier. It starts with better awareness, better decision-making, and a stronger security posture. We're trying to help you, the customer, be at a better security posture. So this solution is going to give you that awareness, going to give you those other data signals so that you can make the better decisions in your estate. One of the things that I said we would cover a little bit earlier would kind of be future things. As the theme here being about security, we're going to be looking more at our security tools and putting more signals from security in the console for you. That's the right thing to do because everybody is more concerned about their security posture. I know if I was back on the other side today, it's not about what the capability can do. It's more about the right signals so I can make the right decisions. Whether that means I have to take a higher level of effort, I need the information to make the right decision. So going forward, we're going to look more at signals from MDE and some of our other security tools to pull in and give you better insight. All right. And with that, that brings us to the end. Again, my name is Dan Aguilary. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.